going to concentrate on talking about protective clothing. As you can see, I'm in gray coveralls. This covers my whole entire body. I prefer the color gray because it doesn't show the dirt as much. These are 100% cotton, so they're cool for working in. And they have lots of different types of pockets for storing stuff. They're quite easy to wash and care for. With coveralls, we also use a ventilated mesh helmet that has an adjustable band inside. Then we use a square folding veil with black steel mesh and drawstring pulls. So I'm going to show you how to put that on. The largest rectangle goes over your face. You're going to pull this down over your collar. Using this drawstring, you pull it straight down and cross it. Bring it back in front and tie it in a bow. To keep bees from crawling up your legs and up your arms, we use a couple of different methods. You can either use a Velcro strap, you can use tape, which is fast and effective. And with your ankles, you can either pull your socks up or use tape. We never use protective gloves in day-to-day beekeeping. We just reserve these for when we're moving bees at night to prevent getting stung. And these will protect you right up to your elbows. So now I'm going to just show you two different types of protective clothing. First, we have Wendy in a sheriff suit. So it's a one-piece suit with a double zipper, and the veil attaches and detaches, and you're pretty protected in that, pretty much 100% protected in that. The only thing is that it can cause overheating a bit. And then Dave is using an example of an apron arrangement with minimal protection. This keeps your clothes free of wax and propolis because they'll stain your clothes and you can't get it out. It's always best to use light colored clothing in the bee yard. Bees are attracted to shiny objects, so you should leave your sunglasses in your vehicle. If you have long hair, it's best to tie it back. And the same goes for jewelry. If you have long dangly earrings, they shouldn't be worn. And if you get stung on your hand and your finger swells up, it could result in your ring needing to be cut off your finger. So it's best to leave your jewelry at home. If you do get a bee in your veil, what you do is you turn your face upwards towards the sun, and the bee will also orient towards the sun, and you just simply go in and pick it out and throw it off to the side. If this doesn't work, don't panic. Walk away from the active bee area. Don't flail your arms. And just simply remove your veil, and then you can pick the bee out.